I'm Anna Davis. I'm the AP art teacher here, and I've been helping coordinate this mural painting effort here at Timpanogos High School. We're excited about the mural. The mural is going to be a beautiful contribution to our school. But as much as anything else, I'm excited that it's been a chance for our students to connect with each other. They've been able to think about their own stories and how they fit into the school. We wanted to celebrate diverse groups of students at our school. You know, whether that's different ethnicities, different sexual orientations, but really just everyone has a different story. Everyone has a different background. So coming together, we were trying to gather from as many stories as possible and as many images as possible to kind of create the story of Timpanogos High School. We've been doing a special collaboration between the AP Art, Latinos in Action, and THS Design Team class to really spearhead this effort.
My name is Dimi Macheras. I am from Seattle. I'm originally from Alaska. I'm a Chicoloon Village, Otna Athabascan tribal citizen, and a graphic novel artist. I've traveled to Utah this year to be part of the Sacred Images Mural Art Residency program. So I've been here for the month. I'll be here till the end of the month working on this mural. The Sacred Images Mural program is sponsored by the Center for Documentary Expression and Art, which is a nonprofit organization based out of Salt Lake City. They've been around for almost 40 years. And one of their projects they do is a mural project annually, and they'll choose a different high school and send an artist and a writer storyteller to collaborate with students on a permanent mural, which will be displayed. This year, Timpanogos High School was chosen, and I was teamed with writer-poet Jimmy Baca, and we presented in front of multiple classrooms early in the month and elicited stories and inspiration from students who wanted to share their stories and their ideas for this mural. And it's been a process of combining everybody's ideas and designs together into one cohesive design that we're using to create this mural. So I've been collaborating with Ms. Davis and her AP art class for this program, along with the design team as well. Working with Ms. Davis has been great. She's very enthusiastic, and she's been really good at hyping up the students and getting them interested in this project. We've got a bunch of students already who have signed up, who have helped, who have submitted stories, who have submitted sketches and designs. It's really exciting to be working in a school where so many students are actively involved and excited, and also very artistically talented. It's one thing I've noticed about this school is that the students are super creative and super talented. There's art everywhere in the hallways. It's great to see it. I'm really excited and honored that part of my design will be permanently displayed in the commons area.
My name is Fynn Pederson. I use all pronouns, and I'm a sophomore here at Timpanogos High School. I discovered that I was gender fluid, biromantic about a year ago, and the school as well as my support systems has helped me through so much as I've discovered more of my identity. I am so grateful that I have been given the freedom to discover who I am in mental ways and in physical ways, and I'm grateful that it has not obscured me in any way from pursuing what I love. I was able to join the girls basketball team, advanced orchestra, and the drama program as well. I'm so grateful for all the support that I've gotten, and I'm grateful that the school is able to give this to so many students.
Hi, my name is Drew Clark, and I'm a junior here at Timpanogos High School. I live in a bicultural household. My dad is white and my mom is from Guatemala. It's been really cool learning about different cultures and taking it into account in my own life. I love learning about it. Also, I've been diagnosed with depression and anxiety my entire life, so I've had to learn how to utilize those things to my advantage.
My name is Talon Gardner. I'm a sophomore at Timpanogos High School. Over my life, I've come to learn that not all diversity is visible. At a young age, I was diagnosed with ADHD and gifted anxiety, which means that I am very good at taking tests and not nearly as good at turning in my homework on time. But I've come to learn that diversity is not just what you're given, but also what you can make of yourself. As we go through high school, there are so many options, So choose to be the best at your thing, whatever it is, whether it's kindness or drawing, whatever your talent is, make sure that you become a part of diversity.
Hi, my name is Catalina. I go by Cata. I am a sophomore here at Timpanogos. I grew up in a Colombian family, and as a person that has lived her entire life in Colombia, I have seen how the Colombian government is and how their corruption is, as they have destroyed many families, they have killed people, and how people can't even get groceries, or it's a struggle just to even get medical services. And myself, I have been a very privileged person because I haven't had the struggles as other people have, which means that the only thing I can do is just help and recognize how blessed I am and recognize that these people need help. And the thing I can do is share this information and let people know how it is to live in Colombia. I also wanted to share how beautiful Colombia is, how nice people are, how our culture is just so amazing, and how I have loved living in Colombia, even though it has been not for me, but for many people who struggle, and it hurts to see how many people are suffering from this whole problematic. So I just wanted to share how my life in Colombia has been and how I can help other people. And I just want people to know more about my country, which I love.
Aloha, Teals.
Hey guys, my name is Levi Matagi. My parents have grown up their whole lives on the islands, and I haven't really experienced that, but from them, it's just really fun. Polynesian people are loving, and we just like being everyone's friends. But going back to the mural, I like the designs, I like how they did it. I like how they implemented my design in one of the claws. It shows the spears, and one of the spears is symbolism of like a warrior, and I feel like Polynesian people, they like to be strong, we like to be warriors, and you guys should try and be one too.
I'm really proud of how everything has come together. Not only is this a chance for students to make their own mark on Timpanogos High School, but we hope as they read stories and connect with each other, it'll be a chance for students to share their stories throughout the history of Timpanogos High School.
Can I talk? Can you hear me? I just wanted to say it's been a real pleasure working here at Timpanogos. The energy is palpable. I feel really excited and really proud of all the students and the work that they did. And I guess I'm leaving tomorrow. I'm a little bit bummed out about that. But I feel like I'm part of the pack now. Go Timberwolves.
One thing I really like about this mural is how all throughout it you can find the six C's, and I think that's really cool because it's a big part of our school and something we really work hard to and strive to build ourselves as a better community.
I really like Nephi's face on it.
I'm so proud of how this mural turned out. We had hundreds of students participate in this project. We have over 100 stories on the website. Over 30 kids helped paint the mural. We had 3 students design the website, 3 students filming a documentary. We tried to spread our reach as far as we could and bring as many students into this process as possible. And magic happened. I'm so proud of how the mural turned out, but I'm also really proud of the connections that were made and the relationships that were formed through this project. It's truly been an honor to participate in this, and it's a legacy that will be up here forever.